Hey everyone, in this video I'm going to review the stock of Dropbox and Box and see which one is a better deal right now. If you're new to the channel, my name is Dan. I do a lot of stock analysis here, so if you're into that kind of thing, hit that subscribe button to check out more videos like this one. Alright, let's jump into it. Alright, so both Dropbox and Box operate in a very attractive industry. I'm talking about cloud storage. Now there are a lot of competitors popping up, everyone's getting into this industry, so that's a negative, but overall the industry's growth is such that, you know, it's going to be an even bigger pie, even if they get a smaller slice of it. There's still a lot of room for growth right now. I've also used both Box and Dropbox, so, you know, I have a first-hand experience. I see how awesome it is to be able to access your files anywhere, edit them, and just upload them there to the cloud. And have people you're working with can then see what you've done and edit on your edits. As well, I like the idea of having a base of subscribers. You know, the more you use Dropbox and the more people you share files with, the more reliant you become on it, I've found. And so you eventually have to get a subscription. And I like this idea where they have, you know, a fixed investment base with these data warehouses. And, you know, off of that fixed cost, they can generate tons of revenue as the subscriber base grows. So I like the business model, and let's just see what the financial statements can tell us. So here's Dropbox's revenue by area. You get about pretty much half US, half other countries. Whereas for Box, it's 75% domestic, 10% specifically in Japan, and 15% spread among some other countries. When comparing the two companies' balance sheets, I noticed that Box has a significantly higher liabilities-to-assets ratio. They also have a lower current ratio and quick ratio, which are, by the way, exactly the same because these companies don't have any inventory. That's not their business. So, I don't love the liquidity ratios for either company, but Box is in significantly worse shape compared to Dropbox there. And interest coverage ratio, okay, Dropbox isn't doing wonderful there either. The money they bring in covers their interest expense about 6 times. For Box, they're not actually making any money yet, so it's negative. And so when you look at it as a whole, Box is a whole lot riskier on their balance sheet. And we're going to have to give them a slightly higher discount rate when we value them. Here's a DuPont analysis for both companies. Ordinarily, you can pick up some consistency here. But again, both of these companies are really in the early stages here. And so it's hard to say what things are going to be going forward. That being said, I mean, Box is clearly behind here. They still have negative margins, although they are improving and they're forecasted to be positive next year. Dropbox is ahead of the game. They've already got 4.5% margins. They've turned positive, giving them a return on equity of about 10%. What I find very interesting is that the market prices these companies very similarly. Here is Dropbox trading at about 27.28 times next period's earnings. They're about a $9 billion market cap there, so they have a lot of room for growth. Also note here, guys, short interest of over 8%, pretty substantial. Given the risks of short selling, you know, unlimited losses possible, it's pretty telling that about 8% of people are willing to short this stock. Now with Box here, you've also got them trading at about 27.5 times next period's earnings. Box also has considerable short interest, and their market cap is only $2.86 billion. So both companies there trading at about the same multiple. So here is Dropbox's growth in revenues over time. You can see it's pretty impressive growth there, but it really isn't the type of growth that's gotten investors' attention. And so they haven't been able to raise as much money from equity offerings. But it's pretty respectable growth there. It's over 10%, probably about 15% per year. Now with Box, we've got a different story here. Also growing slowly, but a little bit slower compared to Dropbox. Okay, so at this point in the video, what I want to do is create an intrinsic valuation model to figure out what is a fair value for the stock of Box and Dropbox and just compare the two to their current price. Now, this is definitely going to be a challenge, a lot more so than it would be for companies that have long operating histories of profits, you know, fairly stable profit margins. We don't have any of that. What we have here are two companies that are just starting to turn the corner and become profitable. So what I need to do is kind of have a vision of what they're going to become and how quickly they're going to get there. What I mean by that is, you know, I have to estimate some revenue growth in the coming years, and I have to estimate how their margins are going to adjust. You know, Dropbox had those very thin profit margins. I don't expect that to last forever. I think they will approach an industry average. Same for Box. And so we have to do a lot of estimations, but let's jump into it. Let's have a look at the spreadsheet and just see, you guys can see what I'm talking about here. Okay, so what I've done here is to kind of make a path to profitability for Dropbox. I've got their base year, the most recent period data we have, and I'm going to assume some kind of revenue growth rate. Based on analyst forecast and based on the past experience with this company, I calculated about a 14.9% growth rate in revenue. And given they're only a $9 billion company and the market for their product is very big and increasing, I predict that they can keep that growth up for 10 years. Afterwards, I assume they kind of drop off and level off into some steady state growth rate. Their net income margin is only 4.5%. But again, I'm going to assume they're going to be able to increase that as they gain economies of scale in their business, and it's going to reach about 22% and stay there. Now that gets us to net income, so we're almost there. After that, we need to figure out how much of that income are they going to have to plow back into the business in the form of reinvestments. To figure that out, I calculate a reinvestment rate based on recent history for the company. That's going to be about 74% based on the past 3-year average. I'm then going to calculate that growth, that reinvestment rate is going to drop off as they mature. After I do that, I have a stream of free cash flows to equity, and I can now value the company. So if we make these assumptions and we have this free cash flow to equity here for every year for the next 10 years, we also have a terminal value. I can then discount these free cash flows back to present value. I can also discount that terminal value back to present value. And that's going to give me the total firm value consisting of the cash on hand, the cash flows for the next 10 years, plus the terminal value. I end up with a fair value of about $11.5 billion or $27.76 per share. Now, keep in mind, I am using a 9% discount rate, which may seem a little high, but there are a lot of risks facing a company like Dropbox, a lot of competition. Now, the situation is a little bit different for Box. Based on their growth history and their forecast, I can only give them a 12% revenue growth rate estimate. Their net income margins, I'm also going to assume they will be improving and getting to that roughly 22%. So based on all of that, I have a very different stream of cash flows from Box. But let's plug in the numbers. Let's use a 10% discount rate because of their increased risk due to their balance sheet. And let's see what Box is worth. Okay, so for Box, if you plug everything in with a 10% discount rate, you end up figuring out that Box is worth about $2.6 billion. With a intrinsic value per share of $16.64, which is actually below what it's trading for by a little bit. One last thing to check is the insider trading data, because insiders normally know more than we do about the company's near-term future. And for Dropbox, you see some insider buys, you see some sells. Let's look at the number of shares involved to get a sense of where we stand with the insiders. And you can see in the past 3-month period or the past 12-month period, the number of shares sold compared to the number of shares bought is actually roughly equal. Now, as for Box, it's a little different. There's definitely, you can see more than twice as many sells as buys in the past 12 months. and nobody bought in the last 3 months, and you got 5 sales transactions. And as we look at the number of shares, you can see about 83,000 shares sold in the last 3 months. Nobody bought any again. So a little more negative for Box compared to Dropbox. Okay, so far Box and Dropbox are very similar as far as their business goes. But in the future, going forward here, I like Dropbox a lot more because they have a few things going for them. They've got Dropbox Paper, which is a real-time editing tool when you work in Teams. It's pretty cool if you haven't checked it out. And you've got this new thing here, HelloSign. HelloSign is basically like DocuSign. It's a way to sign and date legal documents without having to meet someone in person, sign it on paper, and scan it, and so forth. So I like the idea of Dropbox being able to bundle HelloSign with their Dropbox platform and kind of upsell their current clients. I see a lot of good things there. Okay, guys, so here are my final thoughts. Between the two companies, if you saw my analysis, it's pretty clear that Dropbox is the winner here. So if you're going to invest in one of these, go for Dropbox. Now, the estimated intrinsic value I came up with for Dropbox was about $27.50 per share compared to where it's trading right now at about $22 a share. So that's fairly close to the fair value, and you know, ordinarily, I would not jump into this company, but I do like what Dropbox has going on with paper and especially HelloSign. I think the growth rates that they've been experiencing of about 15% could be too low. I could see the potential here for upselling their current clients and even attracting more clients. After all, if you can bundle cloud storage with your document signing software, it just makes sense. So for me, I'm going to buy some Dropbox stock, but I do know that it could be a while before it catches on, and I might just have to hang on to it for a while. But those are just my thoughts. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. Hit that like button, helps me a lot. Thank you for watching.